This tutorial is going to cover Java Web Application Authentication on a GlassFish application server. So this simple GlassFish web application is going to have a servlet that all what it does is returns a simple string if it was successfully accessed, and it's going to have a web.xml file that is going to have the following defined in it: a role that users trying to access the servlet must belong to, and an authentication mechanism, and the realm name. And also this web application is going to have a sun/web.xml file where the role specified in the web.xml is mapped to a group. And next, what I'm going to do is to set up a GlassFish user with a username and a password and belonging to the group specified in the sun/web.xml file. And the last thing I'm going to do is to test run this application. Let's start by creating a new web project. I'm going to call it Authentication Project 01. It's going to be running on GlassFish 3.1.2. And it's going to have a web.xml. And since I'm not going to be using this GSP, I'm just going to delete it. And I'm going to be creating a servlet. It's going to be in com.za.tutorial. And I'm going to call it Authentication Servlet 01. It's going to have a doGet method. And here in the doGet method, I'm going to start by picking up a print writer. So I'm going to pick it up from the response, HTTP servlet response. And I'm gonna be returning a text/HTML to be displayed back in the browser. And I'm gonna use the print writer to return just the string success. Now in the web.xml, gonna start by actually gonna just remove those, and gonna add a security constraint. And here I am gonna associate the authentication servlet 01 URL pattern with users that have the role of user. And here in the login config, I'm gonna specify the authentication method as being basic, and the realm used in the HTTP basic authentication as a file. And in the sunweb.xml file, I'm gonna map the security role user, so this security role, to the group that I'm gonna be defined on the application server, to the users group. Now let me go ahead and try to run this application. It's going to run on GlassFish 3.1.2. And so the application server, I'm going to have here the admin name is admin, and I'm going to set up the password as password. Okay, let's go ahead and fix this problem. So I'm gonna go to Window and Preferences, and I'm gonna go to Java and install JREs. And I'm gonna add, I have the JDK directory here under program files, Java and JDK 1.6.0_25. So the JRE name is JDK 1.6.0_25. And I'm gonna do finish. And I'm gonna be using this one, this JDK. So let me try to run the servlet again. So the admin user is admin, and the password is password. I have to provide this for the application. I'm gonna skip this and go set up a user in the users group that I already specified in here in sunweb.xml. Gonna open the servers view. And view admin console. Admin and password. And let me close this one. And here under default config, gonna go to security. And in the realm, in the file realm, I'm gonna do manage users, and I already had this username defined on the application server previously, and the way to do it is to specify new, and I'm gonna do this user, I'm gonna call it ZA user. And the group list is also going to be users, and the password is password. I'm gonna say okay. And I'm gonna log out. Now let me do this. I'm just gonna restart the server also. And so I'm gonna do run as and run on server. So it still needs the servlet name, which is authentication servlet 01. So let me first try to log in with invalid credential. So invalid user and some password. So it prompted me again. So now let me try to log in with the VA user and password. So here we go. So I'm able to access the servlet that just returned the string success from here.